Okay, good morning class. We're gonna continue today. This is the last lesson of this chapter, chapter 3, lesson 9. Basically, this is the derivative of exponential and logarithmic function. Okay, you can open your book, page 115. Page 115. Okay, now you have known that if fx is equal to x power of n, then basically this is a power function and the derivative of a power function is n times x to the power of n minus 1, right? So this is the formula for the derivative of a power function. But then if you have, for example, you have fx equals to 2 power of x, this is an exponential function. The result of the derivative is not equal to x times 2 to the power of x minus 1. You cannot apply a formula for the derivative of a power function to derive an exponential function. So today I'm gonna teach you how we can derive an exponential function and logarithmic function. Okay? So as usual, everything starts with the mathematical definition of derivative. Limit of h approaching 0 of fx plus h minus fx over h. Yeah. So if fx is an exponential function, let's make it general. Let's say that fx equals to b power of x, as the b is the base of the exponential function. Yeah. So the f prime x, based on the mathematical definition of derivative, will be equal to limit of h approaching 0 of b power of x plus h minus b power of x over h. Yeah, so it's equal to limit as h approaching 0 of, well, if you have a form like this, then actually it's equivalent with b power of x times b power of h, right? Simple algebra, exponentiation property minus b power of x over h. And then we factor out the b power of x limit as h approaching 0 of b power of x, b power of h minus 1 over h. Okay? Now, since b power of x is the value of b power of x is not affected by h, so actually we can put it out from the limit value. So limit as h approaching 0 of b power of h minus 1 times h. So let's stop here for a while. So seeing this process, you know that the value of this one will be indeterminate if we substitute the h equals 0, right? If the h is equal to 0, then b power of h is, b power of 0 is 1, 1 minus 1 is 0, 0 over 0. So you know that actually this will have a certain constant. This will be a constant number. Yeah, and let's say that it is a k. So let's say that actually the result will be k times b power of x. F prime x. So realize that when you want to derive an exponential function, then actually the result is the exponential function itself multiply by a certain coefficient, which the certain coefficient is equal to the limit of h approaching 0 of b power of h minus 1 over h. Okay, and if you look at your book, page 116 on figure 3.9b, you will see the value of k. The value of k is variously depending on the value of the b. So when the value of the b is 2, then the k is 0.9693. When the value of b is equal to 4, you see that when the b equals 4, then the limit is equal to 1.386. So basically, it varies. It varies depend on the value of the b. Now, mathematicians tried to find what value of b that will make the k is equal to 1. So by a computerized method, they found out that when the b is equal to a natural number e, which is the approximation value is 2.71828 something, if the b is equal to e, then the k will be equal to 1. So this conclusion, they got it from the computer calculation. Okay, so it means that if fx is equal to e power of x, then f prime x is equal to the coefficient times e power of x, and the coefficient is equal to 1. So e power of x. So this is the only function that when you derive it, the result is the function itself. So I will read it from your book on page 116, the last paragraph. So the derivative of fx equals e power of x is f prime x equals e power of x times 1 equals e power of x. The function is its own derivative. This fact explains why the exponential function with the base e is important enough to have its own key on your calculator or grapher. The name natural exponential function is used for fx equals e power of x because the number e arises naturally in various places, as does the number pi equals 3.14159. So remember, when you were in 10th grade, you learn type of numbers, and e and pi is in one type of number, which is a transcendental number, right? So they have the same type. So basically it's a special number, like pi is used to find the area of a circle. E is used to find the derivative of the exponential function. So it's really important for you to know about it. Okay, so the first formula that we can get from this lesson is when fx equals e power of x, then f prime x is equal to e power of x. Before I continue to the other formula, I want to give an example first. Example one. If fx equals e power of cos x, then you need to find the f prime x. Okay? So the derivative of fx in this case, remember, if it's e power of, this is a composite function, right? A composite function, and let's say that this is equal to u. Okay? So basically, you are deriving e power of u, which is e power of u itself, times the derivative of inside function, which is the derivative of cosine x, is negative sine x. Okay? So the result is actually equal to negative e power of cos x times sine x. Okay? Understand, yeah? Now I'm gonna continue to show you the derivative of a logarithmic function. And let's start with the natural logarithmic function first. Okay? So if fx is equal to ln x, then what's the derivative? Yeah. So now, if fx equals to ln x, then actually I can say that y equals ln x, yeah? Y equals ln x. And by the definition of logarithmic, then actually this equation is equivalent with e power of y equals x. Yeah, by the definition of logarithmic, e power of y equals x. Now I'm gonna derive both sides with respect to x. Okay, remember that's equation. You can do anything to the left side as long as you can you do something the same with the right side. So I derive both sides with respect to x. Okay. So let's start with the easiest one first. The right one, x derived with respect to x will be equal to 1, of course. Yeah. Now, how about the left side, e power of y? Now, e power of y is basically a composite function, right? A composite function, which is e power of something is the inside, the outside function. And the y is the inside function, which is y itself is equal to an x. Okay, so the derivative of e power of y with respect to x is equal to the derivative of outside function, which is e power of y itself, times the derivative of the inside function, which is y. So I will write it dy dx to make it clear. Okay, so the left side, d dx of e power of y is equal to e power of y times dy dx, which is equal to 1. So then if I continue, then dy dx is equal to 1 over e power of y. Now we know that e power of y is actually equal to x itself, right? So it's equal to 1 over x. So the first formula that if fx is equal to ln x, then f prime x is equal to 1 over x. This is the second formula. The first formula is when fx is equal to e power of x, then f prime x is equal to the e power of x itself. Okay. The next one is about the general differentiation of an exponential function. For example, y equals to b power of x. Okay. If y equals to b power of x, then actually if I want, if I need to do some trick first for this one, I will learn both sides. Learn both sides. So I will have learn y equals to learn b power of x. And you know, again, by the properties of a logarithmic number, then actually I can write it as learn y equals to x times ln b, right? X times ln b. Next, I'm gonna derive both sides with respect to x, like the previous one. So ln y, so d ln y dx, d of ln y dx is equal to x times ln b. Now you know that ln b is a constant, right? So actually it's a coefficient times x. The result is the coefficient itself, the derivative ln b. Okay, and then the left side is actually the same with the previous one. This is a composite function, which is the outside function is ln something and the inside function is y. So the derivative is, the derivative of ln is 1 over y, right? The derivative of ln y is 1 over y, as the derivative of ln x is 1 over x, times the dy dx, the derivative of the inside function. Yeah, it's equal to ln b. So actually, dy dx is equal to y times ln b. And what is y? Y is actually b power of x. So dy dx is equal to b power of x times ln b. Okay, so the third formula for today, if fx is equal, if fx is equal to b power of x, then f prime x is equal to b power of x times ln b. Now, before I explain to you the last one, at the beginning of this lesson, I told you that an exponential function, this one, an exponential function, if you derive it with respect to x, then the result will be the exponential function itself multiplied by a certain coefficient, right? Which is k. And the coefficient is actually equal to limit as h approaches 0 of v power of h minus 1 over h. So now look at this one. It's already quite similar. Then actually this is the k that I was talking about. Yeah, that's the k that I was talking about. So actually the limit as h approaching 0 of b power of h minus 1 over h is equal to ln b. Okay, you need to keep that in your mind. Okay, and then the last property that I want to teach you is the general logarithmic function. For example, if y equals to log to the base b of x. Okay, now again, by the definition of logarithmic, then actually this form is equivalent with b power of y equals to x. Yeah, and then again, derive both sides with respect to x. So I will have d of b power of y dx is equal to 1. And then again, the left side will be b power of y times ln b, right? Times dy dx, don't forget to multiply it with the derivative of the inside function, equals 1. Okay, so dy dx in this case is equal to 1 over b power of y times ln b. And then b power of y is equal to x again. So actually it's equal to 1 over x times ln b. Okay, so the last formula for today is if fx is equal to log to the base b of x, then f prime x is equal to 1 over x times ln b. Okay, so for today, I taught you 4 formulas for derivative. The first one is if fx equals e power of x, then f prime x is equal to e power of x. The second one, if the fx is equal to ln x, then the derivative is 1 over x. The third one, if fx is b power of x, then f prime x is equal to b power of x times ln b. And then the fourth one, the last one, if fx is equal to log to the base b of x, then the derivative is equal to 1 over x times ln b. That's all for today. Thank you.